वही है ना? हाँ वही है। बस 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 बस
बस
थैंक यू सर।
सुन ना खत्म, एक फोटो करा ना उन लोग का।
So how are you feeling coming here?
I've been doing films in Malayalam, but there are one or two Hindi films too, but I could not continue for various reasons. But I wanted this film should be seen by non-Malayali audience too. So we have translated this film into all the South Indian languages, including, I mean, and Hindi. Yeah. It's to reach more. This is the history of the brave, and there is not only love, romance, betrayal, there is a philosophy behind this, which I do not disclose now. Very, very contemporary issues are, you can relate with it. So, it's a special film for me, that's all.
So, do you think that as an artist, it is your responsibility to get something which is there in the past to the audience, and is what does this film mean to you?
Every film is something. What this particular film? Yeah. That is, yes, a very, sir, tricky question. I have already explained why I'm here, why I have accepted the film. This is something special for me. That's all.
All right, give it up, ladies and gentlemen. All right. Can I have the seat on stage, please? Later? Okay.
I have such a vast audience on the first day that no film from our region has done this before. So whenever I have a small conversation with Mamuka regarding this, he asserts that a history is made not just by making a film, but the way it is, you know, like coming out of the box and presented it to you. Everybody gets a mic to speak, and I think the biggest statement will be made when the film comes on screen. Thank you.
So there's one more question which I'd like to ask. Could you actually tell us the layers of characterization? That's very important. So if you can just put a little more light on it.
The film in the posters or in the trailer that you have been seeing is primarily about a warrior class and the rivalry between a neighboring kingdom and this particular region from which this warrior clans come from. So we are used to watching Chinese films where divided kingdoms fight for power. But here, basically, this festival, the word Mamangam represents a festival, a trade festival. And this trade festival, which happens once in 12 years, did not represent just commerce, but it was also the symbol of power. So this one clan of Zamorins who undertook mastering this festival or becoming the master of this festival was challenged by warriors from across the river. So they came up from four different families led by either one of the masters from those galleries. So these people who come from these particular families also had the support of the local people, including members from all the religions and also the poor people. And they would come and challenge the master. I'm just telling you the premise of the story. You have to watch the film. The film has a more than the prima facie slew of characters that it has. It also represents a very strong sense of womanhood, because these warriors are actually sent by women who are much more braver than these warriors, because they don't consider these people as dead. They still continue to wear their ornaments, or they don't change their lifestyle because their son or their husband or their brother goes to the war. So this is also about those women who actually garnered revenge within their womb and also made this war last for centuries in the name of their blood feud. That's it.
Thank you so much. Now, may I please request Mr. Mammootty to come on stage? And please. Questions right now. Please, this is your time to ask questions. Thank you.
First of all, congratulations to your team, Mamangam. This is Simran Singh here. So my question is to you, sir. Mammootty, sir, here on the center. Congratulations to you and the team. The film looks fantabulous. It's very fantastic. So my first question to you is, since it's an untold story, a story that we don't know, we have to be, you know, we have to see that. We have to witness the epic. Tell us about the germ of this idea. When did you thought, you know, we should make a film which should tell the untold story of this epic history?
This is not actually untold. It
has been. But we are, but part of the India is
not
unknown.
Told on screen.
Ji.
Just written about this story many times and many people in many ways.
Ji.
So if you go through the history or you read these books, you will just definitely get inspired to make a film out of it. You can make not only one film, you can make minimum 10 to 15 films out of it. Such a big, vast history, a vast incident about it. So we can take one, we might make one more sometime. Depends. About, see, the it happened for 3 centuries, so you can imagine.
Thank you, sir.
Mamuka, this is Jyoti Venkatesh from Bombay.
Hello, how are you, Jyoti?
Fine. This is not the first time that you have acted in a genre like this. Several Malayalam films you have acted like this. But what was the biggest challenge when you set out to act in a film like this, as opposed to a social film?
Yeah, the two films were, one is Parsi Raja, that is a, what do you call, a story about a king who fought against the British, and that is more about patriotism. And Madakan Biragatha, again, it's a folklore drama, that is again a folklore. This is again more older, maybe, older history, 15th to 18th century it happened, and there are lot many stories. Of course, the character, both all are different. That really attracted me.
But as an actor, what kind of challenges you face when you do a film like this?
Actor is always facing challenges, Jyoti. They're always challenged.
And one more question is that, not many here may be aware of the fact that you started your career as a criminal lawyer.
Lawyer? Not a criminal.
So, do you miss?
I don't miss, but I still am aware of what is happening around me. I miss it, but still, because I preferred to be an actor. That's why I came here. So I should not miss it.
Long back, we saw you in a Hindi film called...
See, there are so many other people.
Dharti Putra.
Dharti Putra, of course.
After that,
he did not mention about Dharti Putra. He was the fight master there. It's the second or third film, maybe.
It was in
96.
After that, why we are not seeing you in straight Hindi film?
Many reasons for that. That we'll discuss later.
Just a minute. May I please call the executive producer of the film, Mr. Vivek? Please come on stage. Give it up, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
See, incidentally, there are two more great actors who have participated in our film. They are sitting in front of the... Say, I don't know, can you manage them also some seat? They will... You can ask something to them
Sudev.
Also.
Sudev.
Mistress. They are enjoying beer being...
Tarun Arora.
My name is Sudev. I am also a small part of this film. I was actually enjoying the view from down there. I'm a little upset to be brought up here, but thank you. Thank you, sir.
He's a celebrated actor. He is a Film Institute guy. He has been awarded as the best actor two years ago. Malayalam Films, best actor. Not only a small guy, big guy.
Hello. Mammootty sir.
Yes.
Is film ko banane mein pura kitna samay laga aapko?
We took almost 2 years. We shot nearly 120 days, maybe? 142 days.
Mammootty sir, and to the other cast.
Yeah.
Sir, my question to you is, we are living in this age where, you know, there are no more boundaries here. Now, there are no more boundaries here. The language boundary is not here. Bollywood actors going in regional films are coming in here in Bollywood. So now we are having this example of Mamangam as well, right, from Bahubali to 2.0 to Mamangam. So what do you want to say about this trend, the change of trend?
Of course, we are getting united again, more strong.
Yeah, please sir, continue sir, please. And to the other cast member, if they can please add what's their input about it.
So the boundaries are getting blurred, and being a North Indian, I never knew, you know, what the culture of Malayalam industry is. And I'm fortunate to be starting my debut with a beautiful industry, which is so content oriented. And obviously to be launched opposite Mamuka. And
you're opposite me.
I'm next to you right now. So it was a wonderful experience, and you know, moving forward, it is going to be called as Indian cinema rather than Bollywood, Tollywood, Mollywood, Punjabi industry.
Correct.
I think, yeah.
Thank you.
And audience is also becoming very, very smart. I think the main hero of the film is the content. And that's the beauty about it.
Thank you. Can you guys please share about it? What do you want to say about the change in the trend?
Actually, I believe the advent of the internet and the accessibility of online data has really made all kinds of content accessible, and now we don't really wonder or worry about the language or the grammar of the content as far as the content itself is effective. And if the story is good, stories are universal and they do transcend languages. And now because of technology, this has been aided more and more, and we are only going to get more and more seamless.
जब मैंने कैरियर शुरू किया था एज एन एक्शन डायरेक्टर तो पहले मलयालम सिनेमा से शुरू किया, तो मेरे को अभी तक याद है मैंने कुछ दो तीन फिल्में मलयालम करने के बाद में स्क्रीन में एक आर्टिकल था मेरे बारे में, इंटरव्यू थी, तो उसमें एक लाइन थी जिसको ब्रैकेट में लिखा गया था कि आई एम ए पंजाबी, मतलब फर्स्ट जनरेशन इन मुंबई कमिंग फ्रॉम ए विलेज इन पंजाब, तो उसमें लिखा था ए पंजाबी डूइंग एक्शन फॉर मलयालम फिल्म एंड ब्रैकेट में दिस इज एग्जाम्पल ऑफ नेशनल इंटीग्रेशन.
Right, may I field this question to Mr. Vivek here? Right, Mamangam has been pegged as the most expensive Malayalam film. Yeah. You know, you want to talk something more on that?
Yeah, it is the most expensive Malayalam film to date. See, Malayalam being a very small industry compared to even the bigger industries down south like Tamil and Telugu. Yesterday, we were in Hyderabad, so I was just telling, the budget of even this film is the salary of an actor in Telugu, and or probably lesser than that in Hindi. But the person I think we all owe this to is a person who is not here, who I really personally miss, because Mr. Venu Kunnapalli, he's a businessman from Dubai. So he's the one who has produced this film, and the vision to do that from an industry like from Malayalam, a small industry where you were not assured of, getting the money back. It's a very difficult thing to do. See, Telugu has a huge market. So, Bahubali doesn't need the entire country to get back the money. You can get it back from Telugu itself. But Malayalam is not like that. Even overseas, we have a market which is only a bit in the Middle East. But this film is going far wider than that. It's going into countries which has never seen a Malayalam film being released. So, that is happening, yes.
That is only the producer's view. He's only marketing the film. That our films will collect in Kerala. We are sufficient for the last 38 years. I am there.
And the vision behind releasing the film in different languages.
No, that was what Mamuka said. Mamuka had this vision that a film like this, which deals with true history of land, should be seen across the country, because otherwise, if we make
simple
this film,
reason is we are not that selfish that we only see the film, we will not allow others to see it.
And a Malayalam film, if it is made only in Malayalam, only Kerala will see the history. So Kerala's history is also India's history, is what he said. I remember him saying that. So so if it is made into more languages, there are more chances of the cinema unifying us as a country. So I think that is a great thing. That's the reason why we wanted to make it. The other markets, as I said, it's not a fantasy film. It's rooted in a culture and a time zone. We had to be true to that time zone. So the costumes, everything is Malayalam, but then the emotions are not. So that's
he's our marketing person. That is why he's marketing. Kannada people knows other languages too. There was a issue that they won't let other languages to be dubbed now. There is. Now it is free. Before we started this. And we are more open. We have no secrets. We will show whatever history we have to others. We have to others. We don't hide anything. We have nothing to hide.
Sir, and it's not easy, sir. It's good to dream, but it's very difficult making a film in four different languages, which has never been done before in Malayalam. We were in Chennai day before yesterday, we were in Hyderabad. This itself is not easy to do. But yeah, we're chasing a dream. So.
Hi, this is Shweta from Filmy Beat. Can you hear me?
Little louder, please.
Shweta from Filmy Beat. Congratulations to the team. It's a great trailer. To the director, actually, I'm really curious about the little boy and how you found him and, you know, his role. Can you help us with it? Some more information. With Achyutan, right?
Chutan.
So he's done, as we could see from the making, he's really impressive. Yeah.
Actually, there was we were searching for a boy like him, who knows martial arts and he has to perform well. He has to do many scenes, emotional scenes and all. We searched many galleries and schools in Kerala and in Kottayam. Puthupalli.
In Kerala.
He's in
I'm from Kottayam.
Kottayam district. Puthupalli is native.
Yeah, he already told us that you've been learning Kalari Paitu since the age of 5.
Yeah.
Okay. And how is your...
There are Kalaris there all over Kerala.
All over.
Still there. There are schools.
Okay.
See, in the evening and morning, they can go and learn there. There is a Kalari in... Where did they go? There is a Kalari near his house. He went there in the morning and he has practiced there.
Okay.
Even during shooting, we were running a Kalari. Kalari means a school.
Okay.
Kalari, Payet is the fight.
Payet is
Kalari is, Kalari actually means school.
Okay.
So, even we were conducting a school during the shoot. Everybody was fighting there.
Well, that
there is a subsidiary. Part of the set was converted into a Kalari and we were practicing. You can see that making.
Yeah. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Komal from Indian Express. Mammootty sir, I have a question for you. It's great to have you back in Mumbai after so many years. We recently also met your son, Dulkar, who's doing Hindi films. First, I want to know what kind of feedback have you given to his films and have he has given to Mamangam?
He has nothing to do with that. He does films, that is the children, no? I don't think he was not supposed to communicate or any... But actually, I didn't get your question.
Yeah, my question is, since because we are more familiar to Dulkar, we've interviewed
my
him.
My son.
Yeah, of course. So I'm asking you, have you seen his Hindi films? And what kind of feedback if you've given
okay,
him?
Okay, I have seen his films. But we are talking about some other film.
Okay. So, I have a question related
to... He has not seen. Even I have not seen the film yet.
I have a question related to Mamangam. Maybe the producer can answer. It is about, halfway through filming, the director of the film was changed. Why was that done? And how much of that have you retained in the film that has been directed by Sir?
I can tell you in one line that it was done in the interest of the film. Nobody does it happily. It is not a pleasant thing to do. So we were left with no option but to take that step. He went to court and, couple of courts upheld whatever we did was right, including Kerala High Court. So I think that's been an unpleasant experience. We have not retained anything from what was shot. It's a completely new film. So I think now we've censored the Malayalam film, the Telugu version has censored the two language of censoring it. I think we're now getting into a phase where, that is behind us and we're looking positively to the future. That's it, yeah.
Hi, Mavidi sir, yeah. First of all, congratulations, काफी जबरदस्त ट्रेलर है और इस तरह की फिल्मों का जब ट्रेलर आता है तो हमें इंडियन सिनेमा पर काफ़ी प्राउड होता है सर अगर बात की जाए साउथ इंडियन सिनेमा की तो ऐसी सी फिल्में आती हैं जो कि काफ़ी इम्पैक्टफुल होती हैं पूरा देश ग्लोबली जाती है बट बॉलीवुड में भी जिस तरह बॉलीवुड को भी आप फॉलो करते होंगे कहीं ना कहीं ये आपको कमी नज़र आती है कि उस लेवल की फिल्में नहीं बनाई जाती या बॉलीवुड फिल्म मेकर उस तरह का रिस्क नहीं लेना चाहते जिस तरह का रिस्क साउथ इंडियन मेकर्स लेते हैं
फिल्म मेकिंग इटसेल्फ इज अ रिस्क फॉर द प्रोड्यूसर सो दिस इज ऑल ट्रायल्स वी कैन नॉट स्टॉप फिल्म मेकिंग देयर आर मूवीज आर फेलिंग एंड सक्सीडिंग सो दैट कैन नॉट बी द क्राइटेरिया फॉर मेकिंग फिल्म्स there are films running, there are good films and bad films are being made. So let's make it and let it be good or bad. That's what our idea is about. And we were confident about the subject and we were confident about the movie. So we made it. We were very sincere and we were very frank about it.
Thank you, sir.
We cannot say that some films are failing, so that the film industry will not survive otherwise.
Maul sir, ek saath mein aur ek question hai. Aap ek bahut hi pura desh aapko pyar karta hai aur aap bhi jis tarah desh mein halaat hain aaj jis tarah baatein chal rahi hain, ek south mein bhi ek case hua, north mein bhi ek case hua rape ko lekar ek ladki ke,
society should be conscious about it. They should change their conscience. They should ask their conscience, what are we and why are we doing like this. So all are about, everybody is concerned about it. What is happening to us? Me too.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Hi, sir. My name is Deepak. I'm a pure Malayali. I'm a huge fan of yours. Sir, so you make from 5 to 8 movies in a year, I think. And this movie itself took you almost 2 years. Okay. My dad is just a 54-year-old guy. He walks 10 minutes, he gets tired. And I see you doing all these stunts and running and you do all these horse rides and all. How do you get this energy even at this age? Yeah, I'm so surprised. I'm a huge fan of yours. Could you please explain it to me?
You are my energy.
All right, one more question, please. Last question.
Hi, my name is Jigar. Hi, my question is to Unni and the other cast members also. How long did you guys take to learn Payattu, if at all you had to kind of do all the stunts? To the director, if you can tell a little about the music of the film as well. I mean, I understand that's also an important aspect of the film. So if you can just share some light about
it. Did you ask me about the stunts?
Yeah, about the stunts and the preparation for your...
The prep stunt. Part with the stunts is totally handled by Shyam Koshal, sir. I just have to... I am personally a huge, big fan of action movies. I enjoy watching them. I enjoy doing it. So the easier part for me was when it is handled by Shyam Koshal, sir. I just have to do it correctly. The way he says it, just do it. If I don't do it, I injure myself. But the fact is that I came out uninjured. And that's the best part. It looks quite horrifying with all the swords and all the elephants around and too much of commotion. We had like thousands of junior artists performing the same Kalaripayattu. It's a difficult art. I'm not a trained Kalaripayattu artist. So it was difficult for me. But then with the proper guidance, I could make sure that... I just wanted to make sure that it looks as real as possible on screen. So yeah, the effort was neat, but then I'm pretty happy that it came out for a project which will be showcased across India. So as an actor also, all the little effort that I've taken in will come out good, yeah. So.
See, with the whole, most of the fights were shot in the night. We were shooting nearly 50 to 60 nights together. Night shooting and day?
I'll tell you one thing. When the night shoot started, everyone told me that कि मम्मूटी सर का एक प्रिंसिपल है 11 बजे के बाद में शूट नहीं करते हैं और ये सिटिंग नेक्स्ट टू मी हमने 2 बजे से पहले कभी इनका पैकअप नहीं किया है तो मतलब अमेजिंग एंड जस्ट हैट्स ऑफ टू हिम कभी भी मेरे को ये नहीं सोचना जैसा आपने बोला कि मैं जो विजुलाइज करते समय के ही जब भी बिगनिंग शुरू की तो थोड़ा सा आई वॉज बिट हेजिडेंट तो मैं इनको जाके एक छोटा सा स्टंट था फिर जाके मैंने मम्मूटी सर ऐसा कुछ ऐसा करें तो ऐसा करें He just opened up, Master, you do anything. He showed me something, some video. I can do like this. Then I went wild in thinking.
I was promoting myself with him.
So it was a great experience. And Unni, this child, amazing, amazing. I can't explain what they have generated on the screen, but you just see it.
Sir, but is there a specific reason why it was shot only in the night consciously? A technical reason?
Happens in the night.
Okay.
Historically,
story.
That thing happened
story
in the
was
night.
That. It is
okay.
That.
And can you share a little about the music of the film as well? Because that is also...
About music, there is 4 songs in this movie. M. Jayachandran is the music director. And Rafiq Ahmad Ajay Gopal is the lyrics.
Sanjit and Ankit.
Our audiographer is Satish.
P.M. Satish and Manoj Goswami.
Sadesh and Manoj Goswami.
Ken is the colorist.
Mr. Arora, could you please share your experience of Mamangam?
Hi, good evening, everyone. My name is Tarun Raj Arora. Well, I would like to thank my lucky stars to get a debut, such an epic project. And when I got this offer, I didn't know this movie is going to be so big. My only interest was to work with Mammootty. And that's how I went and signed this movie. It's been a big bucket list to work with such a legend. And the more and more I got involved with the film, I realized that it was really a very, very big film. And I get to work with such talent, from my co-stars to my director, from the action director. And I am wishing that everybody gets to watch this film. I do play a very important but a small role. And I consider myself, again, very lucky to play a small role, but a very, very effective role on such a big film. Thank you, everyone.
Yeah, now may I please request the whole team of Mamangam to come up on stage for a photo opportunity. Thank you so much.
Thank you.